Greetings, classmates and professors. My name is Olga Sebo, and I'm happy to be in the program with you guys. A little bit about myself. I am currently teaching fourth grade writing and fourth grade social studies along with reading intervention this year. I was pulled from my ESC assignment. My certification is in special education. I've been working for Miami-Dade County Public Schools since 2008, but in a different capacity. I became a teacher in 2016 after I got my degree and I became certified. Like I was saying, I've been working in ESC since 2016. This year, I was moved out of my special education capacity and I was put into the general education area. Fourth grade this year is on a content wheel. There's a teacher that teaches reading and there's another teacher that teaches math and science. We're a team and our students change kind of like a secondary model, like if they were in middle school or high school. I am not a fan, and I will share with you guys why I'm not a fan. And it's going to go a little bit into my concerns, some of the concerns I have. My homeroom is, they have it labeled as the low group / ESC group, which I don't like, but that's how they have it labeled. And the majority of the students, I have about 30 students in my homeroom in that group, are students that have IEPs or 504s, or are students that are pending to be evaluated for special services, special education. And I feel that's a problem that I'm gonna get into later. I feel that it's a problem because there's been over the years a big push for inclusion, for the inclusion models and making sure that our students that are special needs get to socialize with their peers in both an academic environment as well as in other situations socially where it's like PE or and they get to hang out and talk and socialize with their peers. My concern is, how is it inclusion if the majority of the students are students that are special needs and have an IEP? How do they get to be in a setting where they get to speak with students that don't have IEPs, that with their peers that are not special education students? So I have a concern with that. I also have a concern with what is going on right now. Most of you are aware there is a teacher shortage. I was taken out of my assignment because my school does not have general education teachers. My school needs at this moment 3 to 5, I believe, positions for general education. We need teachers. So a lot of our students are not being serviced at my school. There's not a lot of ESE teachers that would before go into the classroom and do like support facilitation. Or the co-teaching model where you had an ESE teacher coming into the classroom and assisting that general education teacher with strategies, giving them support, making sure that the students' goals were being met. So that is something that is very concerning to me as well. I think as the year progresses, I don't think it's going to get better. I think we're going to see it more and more. I am very concerned for our students. I am very concerned about their needs not being met. I am also concerned about teacher burnout. And I am going to be honest, when I started this program, I was in a better position. I was in a position where I didn't need to stress about my students, the number of students I had. And teacher burnout is real, and it's going to get even worse. I have colleagues that have 32 students in a fifth grade classroom. My classroom has 30 students, my homeroom classroom. And some of those students have behavioral issues and we're packing them together. And it can be quite challenging to take care of these issues while simultaneously trying to give our students good, you know, a good academic teaching strategies and just trying to better assist them. It's difficult. It's very difficult. Doing small group with them is very difficult with 30 students, 32 students. Yeah, so those are just some of my concerns. I have a lot. And as I had mentioned before, when I embarked on this journey, I thought I had more time. I said, this is going to be great. I'll be okay. And a teacher burnout is real. There's no time. I hope our administrators are aware. I'm sure they are. Reality is setting in for a lot of them. But yes, I am very concerned. And I'm a little bit concerned about how to do the action research, just because I've never really done it before. But that's not as concerning as the other things I have mentioned. And I'm quite excited to see what this semester holds for us, and to learn and to be a better teacher, pick up on those action research skills to better assist my students, and to overall be a better teacher. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I'm also very sick. I don't know if you've noticed. I'm miserable, but here I am. And thank you guys so much for watching my video.